It's always a sign of great commitment and devotion coming to a service at 6:30 in the morning. We usually reward you with the best breakfast of the year, but that's not something we can do this morning. So those of you who have still come out at 6:30 in the morning without that promise are indeed committed, devoted and stalwart. So thank you. But it is, of course, a wonderful opportunity this morning to celebrate our risen Lord, and I'm delighted that we can do it in the churchyard, and particularly so because when we stay outside, it means we can sing. And so I hope you can sing along heartily with the hymns. Will you please turn to your pink service booklets? It's quite a bit of this service that we'll be omitting just to keep it to a reasonable length so you don't all freeze. Use the introductory paragraph. Dear brothers and sisters in Christ, on this most holy night, when our Lord Jesus Christ passed from death to life, the Church invites her children throughout the world to come together in vigil and prayer. This is the Passover of the Lord. We remember his death and resurrection by hearing his word and celebrating his mysteries, confident that we shall share his victory over death and live with him forever. God. Okay. Eternal God, who made this most holy night to shine with the brightness of your one true light, set us aflame with the fire of your love, and bring us to the radiance of your heavenly glory, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Christ, yesterday and today, the beginning and the end, the Alpha and the Omega. All time belongs to him and all ages. To him be glory and power through every age and forever. Amen. By his holy and glorious wounds, may Christ our Lord guard us and keep us. Amen. hold that. Lift the lid. Did that a little bit too much bigger. May the light of Christ, rising in glory, banish all darkness from our hearts and minds. Thanks be to God. Thanks be to God.
The light of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Rejoice, heavenly powers, sing choirs of angels. O universe, dance around God's throne. Jesus Christ, our King, is risen. Sound the victorious trumpet of salvation. Rejoice, O earth, in glory revealing the splendor of your creation. Radiant in the brightness of your triumphant King, Christ has conquered. Now his life and glory fill you. Darkness vanishes forever. Rejoice, O Mother Church, exult in glory. The risen Saviour, O Lord of life, shines upon you. Let all God's people sing and shout for joy. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
It is right and good that with full hearts and minds and voices we should praise you, Father Almighty, the unseen God, through your only Son, Jesus. Adam's sin, and reconcile us once again to you. For this is the Passover feast, when Christ, the true Lamb of God, is slain, whose blood consecrates the homes of all the faithful. This is the night when you first saved our ancestors, freeing Israel from her slavery and leading her safely through the sea. This is the night when Jesus Christ vanquished hell, broke the chains of death, and rose triumphant from the grave. This is the night when all who believe in him are freed from sin, restored to grace and holiness, and share the victory of Christ. This is the night that gave us back what we had lost. Beyond our deepest dreams, you made even our sin a happy fault. Most blessed of all nights, evil and hatred are put to flight, and sin is washed away. Lost innocence regained, and mourning turned to joy. Night truly blessed, when hatred is cast out, peace and justice find a home, and heaven is joined to earth, and all creation reconciled to you. Therefore, Heavenly Father, in this our Easter joy, accept our sacrifice of praise, your church's solemn offering. Grant that this Easter candle may make our darkness light. For Christ, the morning star, has risen in glory. Christ is risen from the dead, and his flame of love still burns within us. Christ sheds his peaceful light on all the world. Christ lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen. Hallelujah. Christ is risen.
He is risen indeed. Alleluia.
We sing Jesus Christ is risen today on your white sheets.
Jesus Christ is risen today. But the pains that he endured are salvation hath procured. Alleluia. Thou above the sky is king. Alleluia. Where the angels ever sing.
Turn to page 7 on your service booklets. Pray that we may reign with the risen Christ in glory. Lord of all life and power, who through the mighty resurrection of your Son overcame the old order of sin and death to make all things new in him, grant that we, being dead to sin and alive to you in Jesus Christ, may reign with him in glory, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be praise and honour, glory and might, now and in all eternity. Amen. Please remain standing for the Gospel.
Hear the Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Early on the first day of the week, while it was still dark, Mary Magdalene came to the tomb and saw that the stone had been removed from the tomb. So she ran and went to Simon Peter and the other disciple, the one whom Jesus loved, and said to them, "They have taken the Lord out of the tomb, and we do not know where they have laid him." Then Peter and the other disciples set out and went towards the tomb. The two were running together, but the other disciple outran Peter and reached the tomb first. He bent down to look in and saw the linen wrappings lying there, but he did not go in. Then Simon Peter came, following him, and went into the tomb. He saw the linen wrappings lying there and the cloth that had been on Jesus' head, not lying with the linen wrappings, but rolled up in a place by itself. Then the other disciple, who reached the tomb first, also went in, and he saw and believed, for as yet they did not understand the scripture that he must rise from the dead. Then the disciples returned to their homes, but Mary stood weeping outside the tomb. As she wept, she bent over to look into the tomb, and she saw two angels in white sitting where the body of Jesus had been lying, one at the head and the other at the feet. They said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping?" She said to them, "They have taken away my Lord, and I do not know where they have laid him." When she had said this, she turned around and saw Jesus standing there, but she did not know that it was Jesus. Jesus said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping? For whom are you looking?" Supposing him to be the gardener, she said to him, "Sir, if you have carried him away, tell me where you've laid him, and I will take him away." Jesus said to her, "Mary." She turned and said to him in Hebrew, "Rabboni," which means teacher. Jesus said to her, "Do not hold on to me, because I have not yet ascended to the Father. But go to my brothers and say to them, 'I am ascending to my Father and your Father, to my God and your God.'" Mary Magdalene went and announced to the disciples, "I have seen the Lord," as she told them that he had said these things to her. This is the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Please be seated if you have a chair. Well, if you haven't guessed it already, churchyard services are my new favourite thing. Three good reasons. Firstly, we can sing. And I think after a year of being denied singing together, we've now got a renewed appreciation for the importance of being able to sing hymns together. How wonderful it was to do that this morning. Secondly, it helps us to witness to those who pass by. Admittedly, there's not many of them at 6:30 on a Sunday morning. But when we did our services for Palm Sunday and then Good Friday, we had lots of people walking up and down and going past in their cars and on the buses, all of whom looked over and many of whom stopped. In fact, some joined in on the other side of the fence. It's a reminder that our worship and our witness go hand in hand, or at least they should go hand in hand, as we offer our worship so we witness God's love to others. And I think we need to do a bit more of that. And thirdly, very often we find that by being outside, we get closer to the gospel. Most of the action that we hear about in the gospel is outdoor action. And so by being outdoors ourselves, it helps us to connect with the story, to imagine ourselves involved. We get closer to the place of encounter. And that couldn't be more significant than the story we've just heard this morning. We've just heard the story of the empty tomb in this characterful churchyard with a number of tombs that, while not being empty as such, have lost their top stones. The best one is just by that yew tree there, great big box tomb, which has a stone missing on the top of it. How fitting for our Easter celebration. And so it helps us to imagine ourselves with Mary Magdalene and Peter and the beloved disciple, who we hear about peering into an empty tomb, trying to make sense of it. And in this peaceful hour, perhaps we can also imagine that gentle voice of the gardener who turns out to be the Lord. So I rejoice that we can be closer to the action and become attuned to this story. It trains us to look with eyes of faith and hear the gentle calling of our risen Lord. A couple of years ago, we commissioned a heritage report on the church and the churchyard to tell us all the significant things from a heritage point of view. And we were told that the churchyard was of exceptional significance. Well, I wonder whether we should commission a worship and witness report. And I think if we did, we would likewise consider the churchyard to be of exceptional significance. And I give thanks for church wardens and our holy gardeners who've been doing such a wonderful job in looking after this churchyard. It certainly will be of exceptional significance if we go out from here full of joy in the risen Lord. Alleluia, Christ is risen.
He is risen indeed. Alleluia.
Will you please stand for the renewal of our baptism vows?
As we celebrate the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ from the dead, we remember that through the Paschal mystery, we have died and been buried with him in baptism. In baptism, God calls us out of darkness into his marvellous light. To follow Christ means dying to sin and rising to new life with him. Therefore, I ask, do you reject the devil and all rebellion against God?
I reject them.
Do you renounce the deceit and corruption of evil?
I renounce them.
Do you repent of the sins that separate us from God and neighbour?
I repent of them.
Do you turn to Christ as Saviour?
I turn to Christ.
Do you submit to Christ as Lord?
I submit to Christ.
Do you come to Christ, the way, the truth, and the life?
I come to Christ.
Praise God who made heaven and earth.
Who keeps his promise forever.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
Almighty God, whose Son Jesus Christ was baptized in the River Jordan, we thank you for the gift of water to cleanse and revive us. We thank you that through the waters of the Red Sea, you led your people out of slavery to freedom in the Promised Land. We thank you that through the deep waters of death, you brought your Son and raised him to life in triumph. Bless this water, that your servants who are washed in it may be made one with Christ in his death and his resurrection, to be cleansed and delivered from all sin. Send your Holy Spirit upon them, bring them to new birth in the household of faith, and raise them with Christ to full and eternal life. For all might, majesty, authority, and power are yours, now and forever.
Amen.
Brothers and sisters, I ask you to profess the faith of the Church. Do you believe and trust in God the Father?
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth.
Do you believe and trust in his Son, Jesus Christ?
I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again, he ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead.
Do you believe and trust in the Holy Spirit?
I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Almighty God, we thank you for our fellowship in the household of faith with all who have been baptized in your name. Keep us faithful to our baptism, and so make us ready for that day when the whole creation shall be made perfect in your Son, our Saviour Jesus Christ.
Amen. The risen Christ came and stood among his disciples and said, "Peace be with you." Then were they glad when they saw the Lord. Alleluia. Alleluia, the peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Let us offer one another a sign of peace. Alleluia. We sing our offertory hymn, The Day of Resurrection, which again you'll find on your white sheets. And as we do this, Caroline will come and sprinkle you with water to remind you of your baptism. Turn to page 12 of your pink booklet. Lord of life, with unabounded joy, we offer you our sacrifice of praise. As we are fed with the bread of heaven, may we know your resurrection power through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord is here.
His Spirit is with us.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Almighty and Eternal Father. And in these days of Easter, to celebrate with joyful hearts the memory of your wonderful works. For by the mystery of his passion, Jesus Christ, your risen Son, has conquered the powers of death and hell, and restored in men and women the image of your glory. He has placed them once more in paradise and opened to them the gate of life eternal. And so in the joy of this Passover, earth and heaven resound with gladness, while angels and archangels and the powers of all creation sing forever the hymn of your glory. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Accept our praises, Heavenly Father, through your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. And as we follow his example and obey his command, grant that by the power of your Holy Spirit, these gifts of bread and wine may be to us his body and his blood, who in the same night that he was betrayed, took bread and gave you thanks. He broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat. This is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way, after supper, he took the cup and gave you thanks. He gave it to them, saying, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me." Therefore, Heavenly Father, we remember his offering of himself made once for all upon the cross. We proclaim his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension. We look for the coming of your kingdom. And with this bread and this cup, we make the memorial of Christ, your Son, our Lord. Great is the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Accept through him, our great High Priest, this our sacrifice of thanks and praise. And as we eat and drink these holy gifts in the presence of your divine majesty, renew us by your Spirit, inspire us with your love, and unite us in the body of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Through him and with him and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, with all who stand before you in earth and heaven, we worship you, Father Almighty, in songs of everlasting praise. Blessing and honour and glory and power be yours for ever and ever. Amen. Let us pray with confidence as our Saviour has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Though we are many, we are one body, because we all share in one bread. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, grant us peace. Alleluia. Christ, our Passover lamb, is sacrificed for us. Therefore, let us keep the feast. Alleluia. Alleluia.
Love's redeeming work is done, fought the fight, the battle won. The sun's eclipse is o'er, love is set in blood no more. Elders will now watch the seal, Christ has burst the gates of hell.
death in vain, for bid his rise. Christ has opened paradise. Lives again, our glorious King, where death is now my sting. Dying once he all does save, where I victory long grave. So we now where Christ has led, following our exalted head, made like him we rise, as the cross the grave has skies. Triumphant now, ever resurrection
thou. Let us pray. The God of life, who for our redemption gave your only begotten Son to the death of the cross, and by his glorious resurrection have delivered us from the power of our enemy, grant us so to die daily to sin, that we may evermore live with him in the joy of his risen life. Through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Almighty God, we thank you for feeding us with the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him we offer you our souls and bodies to be a living sacrifice. Send us out in the power of your Spirit to live and work to your praise and glory. Amen. We sing the hymn, Thine Be the Glory, on your white sheets.
Above, thine be the grieve, thou, O death, hast won.
The God of peace, who brought again from the dead our Lord Jesus, that great shepherd of the sheep, through the blood of the eternal covenant, make you perfect in every good work to do his will, working in you that which is pleasing in his sight. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be among you and remain with you always. Amen. Jesus said to his disciples, "Come and have breakfast. I hope you have a very nice one at home. Go in the peace of Christ. Alleluia, alleluia.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia, alleluia."